Hi everyone and welcome to a new video. Today we'll be looking at the HP Pro 3400 MT. This is a small micro tower PC from HP designed for office use. On top of that, mine has pretty low specifications as well, but nevertheless still interesting to do full teardown, and while we put everything back, I will try to do some upgrades. Let's start by having a look at the PC.
The HP Pro 3400 MT is probably about 10 years old now. That's really old in computer years, but by upgrading the system with an SSD, it's still suitable and performant enough for the less heavy work of today. Let's have a look at the outside of the PC. On the front of the case, we can find a power button and hard disk LED, the DVD drive, two USB ports, front audio, and a card reader. On the back of the case, we can see the power supply on top, with the power connector, followed by the PCIe slots in a rather unexpected place, which is because the motherboard is mounted upside down, as we can see by the rest of the connections like audio, VGA, DVI, Ethernet, and some more USB ports. To open up the case, there is a single thumb screw. Time to have a look inside. Inside, we can see the power supply, hard disk, CPU and cooler, and memory. Currently, only one DIMM of 2GB is installed. As mentioned, I will also upgrade the PC and will install an SSD and additional memory. First, the disassembly. I'll start by removing the hard disk by unscrewing it. And to remove the power and SATA cables. Now it's time for the DVD drive. In order to remove that one, we need to first remove the front panel. Then we can simply remove the two screws on the side. And slide it out while disconnecting the cables. More cables to remove, starting with the ATX power connector, and the P4 connector. Next up are the SATA cables. And everything for the front panel, like audio, power button and LEDs, USB and a card reader. And finally, the case pen. Let's get the board out of the case now. There are 6 screws holding it in place. There we go. As we could see, the board was mounted upside down in the case. Time to see what is under that CPU cooler by removing it. At first sight, all we see is old thermal paste on both the CPU and cooler. Before I clean that, let's remove the memory. A single 2GB module, as I mentioned before. With some isopropyl alcohol, I can remove the thermal paste from the CPU. And I'll do the same for the CPU cooler, of course. To remove the CPU, we can lift the lever on the side and take it from the socket. This system has a Core i3-2120, But in case you would like to upgrade, the best CPU working in the system would be the i7-2600. Here we have everything laid out nicely before the reassembly. The old hard disk, which we won't put back, an SSD, which will replace that hard disk, the original 2GB of RAM and an additional 4GB, CPU cooler, CPU itself, DVD drive, and of course the motherboard. Looking at that one a bit closer, we can see the CPU socket, two memory slots which can have a total of 8GB as a maximum, one PCIe X16 and three PCIe X1 slots. Here we can find a mini PCIe slot, mostly used for Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Here is the front audio connector, multiple front USB, and the front panel and LED connectors. Here we can find the four SATA ports, CPU fan, digital audio, and PC speaker. Finally, the ATX power connector, CMOS battery, and the BIOS chip. Now that we know how everything looks, let's reassemble it. Starting with the CPU, which we can just insert in the socket as long as the orientation is correct. Then we can close the socket. And put some fresh thermal paste. Followed by the CPU cooler, which we can fix to the board again. And finally connect to the CPU fan connector. Time to insert the memory. I'll try to put in a 4GB and the original 2GB module for a total of 6GB. Not much, but sufficient to match with the rest of the system. Time to put the motherboard back in the case now. After some fiddling to get it right, we can fix it back to the case. Then we can start with the front panel connectors like audio, front USB, the card reader, and the buttons and LEDs. Once that is done, I'm connecting the power supply with the ATX connector and P4 connector. The rest of those cables is to power the drives, for which I will first connect the SATA cables to the motherboard. After that, it's time to fix the new SSD. Pretty handy that this case already has the correct mounting holes for a 2.5-inch drive. Then we can connect the other end of that SATA cable and provide power to the drive. Next device is the DVD drive, which we can slide in from the front. Then connect it to SATA and power as well. And fix it with two screws. Last thing to connect is the case fan, which goes in this brown connector on the motherboard. And we're ready to close up the case. First the front panel, then the side panel. Now that everything is back together, it's time to test if the reassembly and upgrade was a success. Not so much, since nothing comes on the screen apparently. Seems something is wrong. After some debugging, I found out that the second memory slot is causing troubles. Any module I tried, and I tried about 5, worked fine in the first slot, and as soon as it was on the second, the computer refuses to show anything on the screen. Eventually, I ended up putting only the 4GB module in the first slot of the PC. After which, as you can see, I managed to get things working. In the BIOS setup, we can see the specs as mentioned, and we can also have a look and see that the SSD and DVD drive are properly detected. After installing Windows on the SSD and all of the updates and drivers, let's do a quick test with Geekbench, just to have an idea how well or how bad this machine performs. With a multi-core score of 1303, this machine won't break any speed records, but it's still sufficient for office tasks and some web browsing. Especially with the SSD, the system still feels pretty snappy.
Thanks a lot for watching. I really hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please put a thumbs up. If you like this and similar content, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel for more of the same. Thanks again, and I really hope to see you back here soon.